Hello students, today we shall start with the new concept of computer graphics. So as we all know that computer graphics is not only a theoretical concept, so we will have to also see how do we write the programs to implement the computer graphics. So we will have to see through the algorithms, and also we will have to see through the programs of how to convert these theoretical concepts or algorithms into programs. So before going to all those practical things, so we will have to start with the introduction of what do we mean by computer graphics. If you see the word graphics, so we mean that anything which is picturally represented, so you can call it as a graphics. But it is not just only a picture which is called as graphics in computer terminology. Anything that you want to make the display on the digital screen, you have to call that as a graphics. So displaying in the sense, images are not only the things that we display on the screen. So it is the text we display, it is the videos, and everything that we display on the screen will have to be treated as a graphics. So now as per the definition, so what you can say, computer graphics is the display and storage and manipulation of the images and the data for the visual representation of a system. So you have any system or any concept that you want to have the visual representation of it in the digital screen. In the simple words, you want something to be displayed on the screen. So that is displaying and then storing the images, storing the videos, storing the audios, or storing the text, or anything like this, storing and manipulation. So what do you mean by manipulation is, we do a lot of changes over the text or the image or the audio or the video that we have stored in the computer. So therefore, so altogether you call it as a computer graphics. And then computer graphics is not just a programming, it is not just a theory. You can also say it's an art of drawing pictures, so lines and charts and etc. using computers. So using a computer, whatever you want to draw, so that you call it as a computer graphics. And to go to the very basic thing of the graphics is the smallest unit that you draw on a digital screen is called as pixel. So when you have an image, when you have a text or anything that you display on the digital screen, very smallest unit. So for example, with a pen, in a paper, on a paper, so if you want to draw a smallest geometric shape, so what is the smallest geometric shape that you draw on the paper? It is the dot that we draw, isn't it? So in the same way, the very basic smallest thing that you can draw over a digital screen is called as pixel. So pixel is the very fine and finite type of representation that you do. So that means pixel and pixel and pixel together form your images or your text or anything that is represented on the screen. Okay, so next, going to the applications of what do we mean, what are the different areas in which the computer graphics is getting used in our day-to-day life. So we have to say that graphics has become a part and parcel of our everybody's life. And just looking into the different categories or different areas in which the graphics is getting used, you can see the list in the slide. That is CAD, that is computer aided design, representation graphics, entertainment, education and training, computer art, scientific visualization, image processing, and graphical user interface. So each one of this will take up in detail in every slide. So going to the next concept of, that is the first one, that is the computer aided design. So the engineers use this CAD, that is AutoCAD was the software which was first used for this CAD program. You can see there in the image that airplane or aircraft is getting designed in this CAD software. So that means buildings, automobiles, aircrafts, watercrafts, spacecrafts, computers, textiles. So anything that you want to manufacture, you want to get the design done. So before that, using the AutoCAD software, so we actually design it. So it's something like a blueprint that we make. So without using computers, how the building's design was made, it was done with a blueprint. So same way, now the CAD software, it helps you to get the design. So the design is the one that is implemented with the help of this AutoCAD software, and that is called computer aided design. With the help of computers we do the design, and then the computer aided design has been improvised year after year, and there here you can see a realistic design. So there you can see the image of a house that is to be built. So it is yet to be built, and the whole design of how the house looks like after it gets constructed, the architecture can use this 3D image, so 3D design, to design the whole house. So you can also get the feel of going inside the house, and you can also look into how the rooms will look like, and how the measurement of the house is like, and how big the particular room is. So everything you can get the experience, and by that the design is so very effective. So before manufacturing or before building the original things, so the designing is what is one of the basic use of the computer graphics. Okay, next is the presentation graphics. So presentation graphics, as we all know, that we use Excel, that is Microsoft Excel or any other spreadsheets that we consider. So using that, we have the line charts, bar charts, or the pie charts. So what is the use of drawing the charts? So why the data that we have it in the table, is it not enough? No, it is not enough, because say for example you have thousands of data in a table, thousands of data in a table, then using that thousands of data in the table, you want to say something, that is this data is saying that the production detail has production has increased, or say for example the performance of the students of a particular class has detained, they have not done very well in this exam or anything like that. You want to come to a conclusion, that is to analyze the data only with the numbers that you have it in the table is not enough. So for that we always use the presentation graphics. So in this, using the line charts, bar charts, and whatever the types of representations that you use, so it becomes more clear. So just in the chart you can see that the orange and yellow and the blue and the purple and the blue and green, all the different types of line charts, so they are showing us the how the production has increased day after day, or how the students' performance has increased day after day. So like this, it gives you a clear picture rather than only the data. Okay, so as per the pie chart is considered in this slide, you can see. So project management, so how the schedule is going, how the progress is going, so all that you get to know in this presentation graphics. So this is all about the few representative uses of the computer graphics. In the next part, we'll continue with the same concept of the representative uses of the computer graphics. Thank you.